Hi, everybody. In a far corner of Pelham Bay Park is an area known as Cedar Knoll. Cedar Knoll sits on the shore of Shoal Harbor. Across the water on Hunter Island, you can clearly see the large boulder called Gray Mare. This is a remote area of the park, far from the crowds, and full of local lore. Cedar Knoll was once thought to be haunted. According to legend, long ago, two warring tribes met here in battle. After one tribe was vanquished, prisoners were taken, and they were decapitated. Now, on moonlit nights, those braves perform a war dance in the woods, holding their heads in their hands. That story was first published in 1881, but it's pretty clear it was shared among the local people well before that. Headless Indians dancing in the moonlight is pretty far-fetched, but this area has a rich archaeological record. At one time, large quantities of Indian artifacts were found here. Hatchets and arrowheads, made of quartz, and hornstone were so plentiful that archaeologists believe this area was once a manufacturing site for stone tools. This land once belonged to Elbert Roosevelt. He settled here in 1801. And yes, Elbert Roosevelt was a distant relative of Presidents Franklin and Theodore. Here on the beach stands a large rock outcropping called Roosevelt Rock. On this rock, Elbert's son, Isaac, carved his name and date, Isaac Roosevelt, 1833. Time and the elements have badly eroded Isaac's carving. Today, it's almost unreadable. Here's a picture of that carving. It's been highlighted, and I hope it helps. But this is not the only work on this outcropping. There are other more modern carvings here. And my favorite is of two lovebirds, Butch and Anne. Now, I have no idea when Butch and Anne were here, but I'd like to think they're still together. But I do know when PM was here, 1941. PM carved his initials and date a little over a century after Isaac left his mark. PM's carvings are still legible today, while Isaac's is slowly wearing away. It's almost gone in spots. Now, it's the same rock and it's the same exposure, so one would only guess that these newer carvings would erode just like Roosevelt's has. So Butch and Ann and PM, if you're still out there, I'd like to let you know we saw your work. Maybe in another 100 years, Isaac Roosevelt's name will be completely worn away. If your carvings could still be read, maybe Roosevelt's Rock will be renamed after you. When I die.